friends, thank you all of the 100,000 of us that are here today in support of the people of Palestine. You heard the tragedy of the deaths of children in Gaza and on the West Bank. Think what it's like to be a mother or a father and see a building bombed in front of you, knowing your family is in there and you can do nothing to save them and just mourn them for the rest of your life. Look at those huge buildings in Gaza, systematically and scientifically destroyed by aerial bombardment. I have been in those buildings during visits to Gaza. I've visited human rights groups, mental health groups, media groups, and people living in their apartments in those blocks. They too have now been destroyed. I was talking to my friend Mustafa Barghouti this morning in Ramallah. He sends his greetings, his solidarity and his support. And tonight I'm doing a discussion with him on Double Down News about the global impact of what the Israeli attacks are doing. But he also pointed out that the killings on the West Bank are continuing all the time as well, as the Israeli ground forces continue their operations. Yes, they're trying to clear the Palestinian people out of Sheikh Jarrah, a place I have visited and seen the activities of the settlers, as they are doing all over the West Bank. We're here today because the injustice towards the Palestinian people must end. And it's our global voices that will help give succor, comfort and support to the people alongside those settlements in Gaza, all over the West Bank, in East Jerusalem, who are suffering at the present time. And so we've got a message to our government. Our government, which claims, that its foreign policy is dictated by human rights concerns. Well, in the case of Israel, they're dealing with the government that is in breach of the 4th Geneva Protocols, that is in breach of UN resolutions, that is acting illegally in so many ways. So I say end all military cooperation of any sort with Israel. And I say to the Biden administration, elected with such huge and diverse support across the United States, you too must stand up and say to Israel, stop now and we end our military cooperation. And I say to all my colleagues in Parliament and in the Labour Party and all in the trade and all the trade unions, we all have conference decisions calling for the unconditional recognition of the state of Palestine, Palestine. And I conclude with this, because there are many other good speakers who want to follow me. I follow this in three very short points. End the occupation now. End all the settlements now and withdraw them. End the siege of Gaza now. And let us never forget, there are people in refugee camps in Jordan, in Lebanon, in Syria, and a Palestinian diaspora all over the world. Let them have their rights too. Next week we'll be back here, and we'll be back again and again. What we need is a massive demonstration of the people of this country to say, we want peace in the Middle East, we want peace in every country, we want peace for the people of Palestine.